middle adulthood. It is the period of life between the young adulthood and the elderly stage. The most common definition by chronological age for middle adulthood is from 40 to 65. Let's have an overview of the middle life, outlining the roles and responsibilities of those entering the afternoon of life. Middle adulthood is also known as a midlife crisis because it is a transition period where people struggle to find their place in life. Before going to the details, please remember to subscribe this channel. Thank you. Developmental tasks during the middle adulthood. Losing parents and experiencing associated grief. And this is a very difficult time. Then launching children into their own lives, their studies, their profession, etc. Then adjusting to home life without children. It happens when the children leave the home for their higher studies. They might be staying in a hostel, or if they get a job and they move to a distant place for their profession. Then what happens is like the parents will be alone at home, and this is known as an empty nest syndrome. Then dealing with adult children who return to live at home. This thing happens usually in Western countries like US and all. By the age of 18-19, the kids will be moving out of the parents' home and they will start living independently. Sometimes if the thing that planned, if it doesn't work out, then they will come back. Then dealing with those children will be a task for the parents. Then becoming grandparents. This can be enjoyable, but even then there will be some stress associated with it. Then preparing for late adulthood. Then acting as caregivers for aging parents or spouses. So these are the developmental tasks. Physical changes, or the changes that happen to one's body during the middle adulthood. During this time, the aging is inevitable. By the age 64, the primary aging signs will show to appear, like gray hair, thinning of the hair, then wrinkles will appear, then the need for a reading and a bifocal eyeglass, then sometimes hearing loss. Internally, changes are taking place, as well as these external changes. The decline in major organs like the lungs, heart and digestive system. And addition to this, women undergo menopause, usually between the age of 42 and 51. And this aging is known as primary aging. It means that the changes are inevitable. Anyway, all these changes will happen to everyone, regardless of the race, ethnicity, culture, or socio-economic class. These changes will happen. Then secondary aging. This is the result of unhealthy behavior, such as smoking, drug use, unhealthy eating, alcohol abuse, and this unhealthy eating can lead to obesity. Then the lack of exercise, etc., can help the secondary aging process. The death rate for this group remain relatively low, but major of the two illnesses that can affect the health during this age are heart disease and cancer. Several studies that has found that the leading cause of death for males aged between 45 to 65 is heart disease, and it is followed by cancer. In females between the age 35 to 64, the leading cause of death is cancer. So in male, because of the lifestyle, the heart disease occur more, and in females the leading cause of death is cancer. So primary aging, it is inevitable, and secondary aging, it is because of your unhealthy habits. Then cognitive changes. Some aspects of intelligence, such as vocabulary skills, it actually increases until the age of 60. Through experience, flexible thinking, and higher level of intuition and adaptability, and the support of friendship that have been nurtured over the years, this age group, this middle adulthood group, typically conquers the challenges artfully and with expertise. So challenges will happen, but through the experience and with the support of the friendship, they will conquer all these things. Then fluid intelligence. It is the ability to process new concepts and facts quickly and creatively. It includes abstract reasoning problem, then independent of previous education or learning. Usually all these things, that fluid intelligence, it peaks in adolescence and then it starts a gradual decline between the age of 30 to 40. That is what the researchers says. So the fluid intelligence, that is to process new concept, that will decline by the age of 30 to 40. On the other hand, crystallized intelligence, that is stored knowledge gained from experience and education, it become higher as the people ages. For example, the mathematical or chemical formulas, then vocabulary and history dates, etc. are crystallized intelligence. They are stored knowledge and it is gained from the experience that becomes higher. Emotional changes that happens during the middle adulthood. During this stage, there are people who struggle with the contributions to the society. Some people will contribute and some people doesn't. They may be busy raising the children or pursuing the career. So those who are contributing, they experience generativity. It is a sense of leaving a legacy. On the other hand, those who are not contributing, they experience the feeling of stagnation. They feel like they are stopped somewhere. They are not with the flow. So this kind of feeling can happen, depends on every individual. Then people experience feeling of regret about what they have left behind or have not done yet. People feel like, oh, I could have done that, I could have done this, but the time just went off and I cannot do anything. That kind of feeling can make you feel regret. As you age, you might begin looking back on the earlier decades of your life. Sometimes you feel very happy and you might feel relief, but sometimes there will be regret. These feelings changes from individual to individual. Then there will be a sense of uncertainty and instability. It is associated with the idea that one has not found their place in the society yet, and they may have find it difficult to find a place in the society. So this idea, that is, they didn't find a place in the society, can make them distressed. There will be uncertainty and instability in their life. The middle age, the middle adulthood, it is also known as the midlife crisis. It is a transition period and the people struggle to find their place in life. Some people have the feeling of aimlessness or loss of life purpose. They feel like they didn't reach anywhere. That kind of feeling can happen. Then there will be self-doubt about their skills and abilities. Then there will be concern about appearance and how others perceive you. The youthfulness or the young age has gone, and the middle adulthood is a time of decline. So the physical changes, it will be visible, and you, that concerns you. You are concerned about the appearance, and you will feel worried about how others perceive you. Then there will be changes in energy levels, from the increased restlessness to an unusual fatigue. Then there will be mood changes, including anger, irritability, and sadness. And hormones also plays an important role in your mood changes. More than that, there are studies that shows the middle-aged individuals have meaningful intimate relationship, including those who have been married for several years. They are happily married and they are having a meaningful life. And several developmentalists, they found that most of the people in this age group have less problems with their children and they have a better relationship with their parents. So certain changes will happen, and it is different from individual to individual. Physiological changes. We have learned the physical changes. Physical means the changes that appear in your body. But physiological means the body's functions. There will be changes in vision, hearing, more joint pain, and weight gain. The vision is affected by age. The middle-aged adult often have trouble seeing up close. Then we tend to associate hearing loss with older adult, but the onset of the hearing loss is the middle adulthood age. Weight gain. It is sometimes referred to as the middle age spread, or the accumulation of the fat in the abdomen. It is one of the common complaints of midlife adult. Men tend to gain fat on their upper abdomen and back, but women tend to gain more fat on their waist and upper arms. Many adults have surprised at this weight gain because their diets have not changed, but they are gaining weight. This is because of the metabolism change. The metabolism, the rates will be slow by 1/3 during the midlife. Another biologically based change that occurs in the midlife is climacteric. During midlife, men may experience a reduction in their ability to reproduce. Women lose their ability to reproduce once they reach the menopause. Menopause is the period of transition in which the women's ovaries stop releasing egg, and the level of estrogen and progesterone production will be decreased. After menopause, a woman's menstruation stops. In case of men, they do not lose their ability to reproduce as they age, but they tend to produce lower level of testosterone and fewer sperm. So there will be decrease in the libido. And this is known as andropause in men, menopause in women, and andropause in men. So these are the physiological changes that happens during the middle adulthood. Now let's have a quick recap on what we have learned. We have learned the developmental tasks, the changes like physical, cognitive, emotional, and physiological changes that happens in the middle adulthood people. The midlife turmoil, it brings about positive changes that don't require professional help. So there will be negative changes and positive changes. In the positive changes, you may become more spiritual. or you may decide to volunteer so that you feel that your life has more meaning. So this is a positive change. And sometimes the changes can bring about openness to new ideas. You may explore new things and it could bring insight and creative solutions for the problems. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe and share. Thank you and keep smiling.